Hello everyone, welcome to Lukman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 7th November 2020. So let us see which are the important articles. So all of the articles largely relate to our mains examination. So we'll take input from this article accordingly. First article on page number 6, alumni guidelines. So recently Supreme Court in one of its verdict has given the specific guidelines related to alumni given to the separated wife and children from the husband. So until now there were no specific guidelines, and therefore the lower judiciary used to have some kind of different judgments or kind of alimony given to the women or separated women and children. Okay, so that's why the uniform guidelines throughout India are to be now followed by all judiciary. So what these guidelines talks about, which are the constitutional safeguards related to women when they are separated. Okay, so this is the significance of the judgment it is talking about. Okay, so what is the present situation? Yes, in India, though more girls are going to school now, for many inevitable reality seems marriage before completion of higher education. Girls are married off early and bear children long before they should. This leads to poor maternal health and is one of the root causes of high levels of child stunting and wasting in India. So one of the main reason is that the girls are married off very early. We can say that even before 18, that is legal age. So such kind of let's say incidences leads to poor maternal health, and ultimately the child from that mother with poor maternal health largely we can say that has child stunting and wasting problems. Okay, there is also the possibility of marriage not working out of varied reasons, leaving the girl and young woman in extreme distress because often she is not financially independent. So this is the reality. You should directly use this in your essay paper when the question is talking of, or the topic is related to women. And we can say the society paper, GS1. Okay, so directly you can give this reality when the question is talking about even the nutrition, maternal nutrition or even child nutrition, you give these points. What are the constitutional safeguards in this respect? Article 15, clause 3, which states that nothing in this article shall prevent the state from making any special provisions for women and children. So basically the article 15 is that the state will not have any kind of unequal treatment towards people of India or citizens of India. So this is the fundamental right. However, the clause 3 gives exception of that the government should make such positive discrimination, we can say that, towards women and children and for their empowerment. Okay, so such special provisions, like for example reservation to the women, or we can say that some policies and schemes for their empowerment, jaise stand up India hai financial empowerment ke liye, ya fir hum bolte hai ki children ke liye for nutrition right to education act is there, or we can also say that ICDS scheme, midday meal schemes are there. So yes, read together with article 39 DPSP. Article 39 DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policies. So which directs state policy towards equal pay and opportunities for both men and women, and protecting the health of women and children are two constitutional safeguards. Okay, so fundamental right, article 15 and DPSP 39. So on the basis of these articles, the Supreme Court has given the guidelines. On 4th November, the Supreme Court leaned on these two articles and host of other laws while hearing a dispute between Mumbai-based couple and set down comprehensive guidelines on alimony. The court ruled that an abandoned wife and children are entitled to maintenance from the date she applies for it in a court of law. Okay, so the maintenance is to be given from that date. Guidelines to be followed by family courts, magistrate and lower courts on alimony cases. Given the large and growing percentage of matrimonial litigation, some clarity was necessary. The cases are known to drag on and acquire cobwebs, worsening the misery of vulnerable women. The court laid down that while women can make the claim for alimony under different laws, including Domestic Act, Domestic Protection Act, or Section 125 of CRPC, or under Hindu Marriage Act, it would be inequitable to direct the husband to pay maintenance under each of these proceedings. Okay, so any one proceeding is to be followed by the courts, or any let's say single law under which the maintenance is to be provided. Conclusion: for women in India, especially the poor, who are often overlooked in discourses, the top court's word that maintenance law will mean a little if they do not prevent the dependent wives and children from falling into, we can say that, yes, destitution and vagrancy offer a glimmer of hope. So basically it is for women empowerment, especially those which are separated from the husband and which are financially not independent. So the kind of maintenance money is to be given for their let's say survival, their children's survival. This is very much important, we can say, provision with respect to that. Okay, yes. Next article, Bidan, India and comfort in the old normal. So the context of the article is that if Bidan is to be elected as new president of USA, then what policy changes will happen towards India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, or even the let's say overall international order. So what policy changes will US have? So the article is discussing that part. Okay, so let us try to understand from this article. Yes, possible changes in policy, foreign policy of USA towards India and international order if Biden is elected as president. So yes, still the results are not out, the final result is not out, but yes, there is possibility that Joe Biden will win this presidential election. Policy towards Afghanistan, if he is elected, what will happen? So if you go to the background, when he was the vice president and Barack Obama was the president, he was tasked with the building an alternative plan to Afghanistan. Mr. Biden fought long and hard, building a multiple visits to the region, and suggested that US did not need more troops, instead it needs out to pull, okay, or let's say needed to pull out those troops. And he called provided counter-terrorism plus plan. Eventually Mr. Obama did not go with the Biden plan and ended up with following military's plan for surge of extra troops instead. A decade later, it was President President Donald Trump who picked up ideas similar to Biden plan, and when he ordered large scale pullout of US troops, limited US presence at bases. ठीक है, तो ये अफगानिस्तान से इन्होंने अभी रिसेंटली हमने देखा है that in 2018-19 he ordered to limit the forces in Afghanistan and focused on reconciliation with Taliban. Okay, towards Pakistan, on Pakistan, the country that gave him Biden one of its highest civilian honors, Hilal-e-Pakistan, Mr. Biden favored a policy of engagement in order to deal with Taliban. Okay, towards India, while Mr. Trump owned the Indo-Pacific policy later, the policy owes its origin to Obama-Biden administration that first focused on Asia-Pacific. When in New Delhi in 2015, Mr. Obama signed the first India-US vision statement on the Asia-Pacific. It is also likely that Mr. Biden will build the military foundational agreements with India, strengthen military cooperation, and push for sale of military hardware. On visas, Mr. Biden gave Indian Americans some assurance at a campaign last month. So visas, the liberal we can say that visa regime can be adopted. Friction areas, where can be the friction areas between US and India? So yes, where there is likely to have some friction with the Modi government, especially given India's pending review by US Commission on International Religious Freedom. तो कौन से प्रॉब्लम्स यहाँ पे बताए गए, पर्टिकुलरली वोकल अबाउट जम्मू कश्मीर, द सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट एक्ट, कम्युनल एंड कास्ट बेस्ड वायलेंस, एक्शंस अगेंस्ट एनजीओस एंड मीडिया फ्रीडम्स. Okay, so these are the areas there can be frictions. International outlook, above all, Mr. Biden's foreign policy will be watched for just how much he reverses Mr. Trump's pullout from multilateral world order, including World Health Organization, UNESCO, UNHRC, then agreements such as Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, okay, Iran nuclear deal, Paris Climate Accord, and transatlantic and trans-Pacific alliances. So he will be also watched for concrete measures he take in order to strengthen the rule-based international order. So yes, at international level, he will whether he will focus on reversing the Trump administration decisions of withdrawing from the international institutions like UNESCO, UNHRC, even the funding to WHO, all these things will be looked for in future if Joe Biden is elected as US president. Okay, so in future when he is elected again, there will be more and more articles. So for this year's mains examination, this kind of question will be important, because once there was question in mains examination in international relations, examine or analyze the impact of coming back of Vladimir Putin, or let's say election of Vladimir Putin as Russia's president in the international order. Unka impact pucha gaya tha. Okay, in mains examination, UPSC mains examination. So similar kind of thing can be asked, because US and Russia are one of the significant most important countries at present who has huge influence on world order. Okay, so that's why it becomes important for our examination. Next article, market dictates and blow against equality. Yes, the article is having context that is talking about the various taxation tax implemented on essential commodities, especially which are very much needed for vulnerable or marginal sections of society, and these taxes affect the dignity of the people and fundamental rights under constitution. So one of the example it is talking about in this article, the context here is that various equipments which are needed by the, what you can say, Divyang people, okay, for example wheelchair or hearing aid or we can say that other such equipments, they are taxed under GST. And one petition in Supreme Court recently said that such kind of taxes on those equipments affects their dignity. Okay, so ye jo abhi Supreme Court is going to hear that case, so this article is discussing this issue. Okay, yes, so what is given here, relation between tax and fundamental rights here. Okay, on October 27, the Supreme Court of India heard brief arguments on constitutional validity of levy of GST on mobility aids used by disabled citizens. Okay, okay, so taxes have direct bearing on how society is arranged. The nature and rate of tax imposed on product can impinge on both personal freedom and person's right to be treated with equal care and concern. Very good statement. Directly it can be used, impact of taxes. Okay, so top court in Canada and Colombia, among the others, have recently held to examine whether or not to an imposition of tax violates fundamental right. Okay, so similar kind of situation that has arisen in India now. So whether tax, a particular tax, impacts on fundamental rights or not. Okay, so before starting this discussion, I would let you know, like you to know that what happens is, generally judiciary does not interfere in specific legislative functions or executive functions. For example, the kind of taxes they are imposed, or we can say that the sanctions through the parliament, budgetary we can say provisions, the judiciary has refrained to review those kind of things up till now. Okay, koi bhi aisa ek tax hai, koi bhi cheez hai, to wahan pe generally wo hum bolte ki legislature ka domain hai, it is domain of legislature and executive. However, the judiciary, whether judiciary should come up with the review of such kind of taxes which have bearing on fundamental rights of the people, So at world level, or we can say that in Canada, Colombia, all let's say the judiciary is looking into this factor. So in India also, Supreme Court can in future look into that. The GST regime was launched amid much fanfare in July 2017 with the idea of not only simplifying India's complex and multilayer tax structure, but also view of fashioning out carrying a country into unified common market in which levy of GST will subsume almost all extant indirect taxes. Okay. So at the time of inception, the central government claimed that the causes of liberty and equality would benefit from the states pooling their sovereignty together with union. Okay. However, what we have seen since is that the withering of states' fiscal autonomy. This is visible from recent, we can say that, abhi humne ek article discuss kiya tha, right? How the GST or the changes brought by the GST are reducing states' fiscal capacities. So, humne usme facts bhi dekhe the kuch. It is the dictates of the market alone that appear to determine how and what goods are taxed. The levy on the commodities used by the disabled is a prime example of this. Okay, so basically the market alone is dictating this, the government leaving GST on such mobility aids. Why? Because the government argument, you can see here, despite this affront to the dignity, the government claims that it cannot relieve mobility aids from taxation because to do so will disincentivize domestic manufacture. So to protect the domestic manufacturer from the competition at the international level or world market, so this is done at domestic level. However, the counter argument to the government is that many other products that are essential to human needs are exempt from the tax. Notably, in July 2018, following the sustained campaign, levy imposed on female personal hygiene products, tampons and sanitary pads was removed. So it is now 0%. Okay, so tax places a prohibitive burden on ability of disabled citizens to access the most basic goods to lead lives with dignity. So this is important. The basic, we can say that for every human being is that to live with the dignity, and this affects the dignity of those divyang people. International practices, the GST Council can take a leaf out of books of Canada and Australia and grant a complete exemption on levy imposed on mobility aids. So in these countries there is complete exemption on such mobility aids, on taxation, any kind of taxation. In conclusion, taxation after all is a tool that is intended to augment general welfare. It is time we recognize that an unreasonable levy can deeply compromise fundamental human needs. To free taxing statute from ramparts of constitution is to risk the entrenching of inequality. So means taxation laws should also focus on ensuring social economic equality. Okay. So because they are also focusing on general welfare. And in doing that general welfare, one should be, ensuring that any section of society is not left out. Okay? Such kind of question like this statement directly to free the taxing statute from the ramparts of the constitution. Ramparts, yani ki yahan pe important provisions like fundamental rights, is to risk the entrenching of inequality. Analyze the statement with the help of suitable examples. तो आपने ये एग्जांपल देना चाहिए मोबिलिटी एड्स का. ओके, सो यस, सम इंपॉर्टेंट कैप्शंस एंड कोटेशंस. दिस टैक्सेशन रिलेटेड सम इंपॉर्टेंट और गुड, वी कैन से दैट कैप्शंस हियर. सो एसे रिलेटेड टू, वी कैन से इकोनॉमी और टैक्सेशन स्पेसिफिकली, और इफ इट इज रिलेटेड टू सोशल जस्टिस. And governance. Fine. So yes, these were important articles for our mains examination specifically. So for further information on editorial discussion classes or ED classes, wherein in-depth analysis of all these mains related articles is done by Ansari sir and team, you can contact Lukman IAS. Thank you.